Section 8.4, PI Interface Configuration Utility. Well, finally we get to the what I've been claiming is the easier way of configuring interface, this graphical user interface for interface management. I've been so far talking over and over again about how you manage the batch file, and that is obviously its primary purpose. But there's a whole there's a whole group of other things that you can do with this. You can use it to install services, to view the log files. That's actually one of the more very useful things about that. I don't have to go out to pypc.log like you saw me in the last exercise. You can configure the buffering, and you can create specific monitoring tags. But again, primarily, it's the managing of the batch file, setting those switches in the batch file that really is the most useful here. With ICU, you can either create a new instance or modify the current configuration. So let me show you how you would use this or launch this. You can launch this from within System Management Tools by choosing Tools, Interface Configuration Utility. But just so you know, you can also find this within the Start menu on its own. If you go into Start and then PI System, you can find it listed there as well. So let me go ahead and I've already got a copy of it running, so I'm going to switch over to, it's called PI Interface Configuration Utility, or ICU for short, and you can either build a batch file from the executable, or you can edit the existing executable, and that's typically more typically what people do. Now, when I load this, you'll notice it's looking for both .bat and .new files, and also bat underscore new. We do incorporate, as I said, .new files during upgrades so that we don't overwrite your existing batch file. So if I look at my, here it is, my pyping.bat, this is the one from my, it's an existing interface that I just configured in my last exercise. We're going to read the switches, parse out those switches, and then place the specific things like point source and interface ID into specific fields in ICU. We're also putting things like the host name, etc. So we're parsing out the contents, scan classes, etc. And now we've stored that information on the module database in such a way that other applications that need that information can now get to it. Once you've registered an interface with ICU, well, that's one of the beauties of storing this centrally. Other applications, like Auto Point Sync, for example, can make use of that information. And there's other utilities as well that make use of that information. Now, just so you know, as I just mentioned earlier, this is running on the interface node, on the remote data collection node. However, you do need to have access to that PI server so that you can get access to the module database. And in fact, you need write access to the module database. Once we make changes and store those changes, like for example, if I were to add a brand new scan class, let me add a new scan class. Let's add a 5-minute scan class. We'll go 0, 0, 5 minutes, 0 seconds. We'll offset that 0 from the current time. Once I've made changes and saved those changes, what you'll notice is that batch file is no longer going to be editable. It's going to be set to read only. Now I've just gotten a message. Let's take a look at what that is. And it's a nice little warning saying, by the way, remember, this will not take effect until the next time you stop and restart. I can tell from this interface it's already running. If you notice, there's a stop button because this particular interface is already running. Let's look at the file itself. Here's the file. It has just been edited. And if I look at it, it looks completely different than before, and we get this warning, do not edit this file. Also, if we look at the properties, properties are now read-only, and that's because it's currently being managed by Interface Configuration Utility. One final point, within the Help menu, really a very, very nice feature is it's going to make a link out to the interface manual. So if you click on this, it's simply going to go ahead and launch that interface manual, so you won't have to go out and look for it.